Hello friends, myself Elia R. Chandani, Assistant Professor from Department of Electronics, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see the topic Multimedia and Hypermedia, which comes under the subject Audio-Video Engineering. So what are the learning outcomes? At the end of the unit, students can come to know or compare the terms Multimedia and Hypermedia. Similarly, they can be able to select proper audio and video systems for different applications. Thirdly, they can classify and differentiate between different file formats of images. Nextly, they can compare 2D, 2.5D and 3D types of animation. So basically, what is meant by multimedia and hypermedia? So for this, we can take an example. So whenever you go to purchase a television, the television vendor gives us some specifications about the televisions, that he says that it is a HD television, the television has high speed internet. Even though when we go to purchase a computer, then at that center the vendor also gives us some specifications of that particular desktop or laptop, as it is having a good sound, good picture, and also has high-end processors. Above all, these are the examples or different views from the different persons which are having different backgrounds. So basically, what does multimedia mean? So multimedia can be defined as an integration of computer controlled information such as text, images, audio, videos, graphics and animations. So this can be seen in this block diagram. So multimedia, it is having the input from graphic, audio, video, animation, text and virtual reality. So the information here can be represented, it can be stored, transmitted and processed digitally whenever we require. Hence, the multimedia term is widely used for different things. So what are the components of multimedia? Multimedia is always expressed in different forms of components, such as if we can take an example of a multiplayer online game. Here it is an augment, it has a augmented reality where the number of players get log in into the game and they start to play the game. Nextly, when we take an example of a shape-shifting television, here we can take an example of online election polls. Here the polling graph or the polling pie chart goes on changing as the results come out. Nextly, we can take an example of digital camera, where we can use different kinds of filter for taking up the pictures or record a video. Nextly, a web-based video editor, which can be used for the editing of the video. And if we take an example, that is some video softwares which can be used for editing scenes in the movie and so on. So multimedia is an important and has some interesting points for the engineering students, so that it also gains some interest and understands the multimedia, how the multimedia works. This also gives them a wide variety of research topics in multimedia. So basically, what are the different components of multimedia? Here first we will see the capture devices, which include audio mic, keyboard, mice, video camera. Then there are storage devices, which include hard disk, CD-ROMs. Then there are communication networks, which include Ethernet, token ring, ATM, internet, intranet, display devices such as HD monitors, color printers, good quality speakers. So these are the components of, basic components of multimedia. So how a multimedia file is processed and coded? This includes some two to three different steps. First, the audio, image or the video is processed. Then a particular algorithm is used for processing the contents. Nextly, the multimedia content is analyzed. Here, analysis is done whether the algorithm which is used is compatible with the content or not. And fourth one is media security is provided so that the multimedia file which is created has some security. Nextly, multimedia system support and networking. Here we require system support and networking for the purpose of distributing the multimedia file onto the network. So the system support generally includes network protocols, internet and wireless networks, operating systems, servers and clients. Remember, the sequence, it is in a proper sequence. Nextly, the multimedia tools and end system applications which are used here are, it includes hypermedia systems, UI, that is user interface, authority systems and integration of other tools. This also includes some computer supported learning, design and applications in virtual world. So how did multimedia develop from past to the present? So this is one of the basic picture of a camera which was developed in 1890 by E&HT company, and it was known as Anthony model, which was developed in 1890. Nextly, we can see the Edison gramophone, which was used to store and to reproduce the audio and the sound signals. Nextly, then there was the development where the evolution of audio storage media devices was done. First, here you can see this is the cylinder type of a record, which is known as Edison cylinder recorder. This is the polyvinyl recorder, which is generally used in gramophones. This is the media reel, which includes or which has electromagnetic tapes, which has audio as well as video data. Then came the smaller, that is the audio cassettes, and nowadays we are using the CDs or the DVDs. So basically, what is hypermedia? Hypermedia is or was introduced by Ted Nelson, in which the contents which had text as well as other media content such as graphics, images and specially continuous medias. So the best example of the hypermedia is World Wide Web, which uses hypermedia, and it is existing today also. Nextly, hypertext markup language. Here HTML is a language which is used for publishing the hypermedia on the web, defined by using HTML and derived elements, which describes the formatting and structuring of the document. It uses ASCII code, hence compatible for all computer hardwares. And currently we are using HTML 4.01 and HTML 5.01 nowadays. So this is an example of an HTML document which has or which is divided into two parts, that is head and body. Here, this is the starting point, that is HTML. Here you can write the title of the content of the document. Nextly, here the body includes the total explanation, brief explanation about that topic, and then the HTML document ends over here. So this is an example of an HTML document which includes a author name and the written book about that particular author. So students, give an example of an HTML document by pausing this video. Yes, so these are the assignments for you people. First, what is meant by multimedia? Secondly, discuss the components of multimedia. And thirdly, write the difference between multimedia and hypermedia. So these are the references for you people so that you can solve the assignments. Thank you for watching the video.